Good afternoon and welcome again to Channel 48. Thank you for tuning in on this afternoon. I'm here with two of my tablets, the P7500 tablets, as well known as the P4. And I made two nice ROMs. I put two nice ROMs together for this for these devices. As well supported is the 7510, that's the P4 Wi-Fi. And that is all with thanks to Mr. DKETF. DKETF had a development for this device somewhere in 2019, and then it all ended and it stayed on Nougat. And you know, the sky above is gray, but the ROMs from DKETF are to stay. And that means that I will create several models from that ROM, that engine, it's good engine, and especially the Nougat. It's working really nice, and we can watch live TV and do all sorts of nice things with this device still, peeps. So no need to throw it away or to put it aside. You know, just install the right firmware onto it and you will be amazed of how this little device can still amuse you on daily base as maybe a live TV player, or maybe a music player, or maybe, you know, a nice player that you will connect to your amplifier. This thing has a good, very nice sound. You know, the DAC, the DAC digital analog converter in this device is pretty good, as I could find out, you know, when I connected it to my stereo. Nice 10-inch screen. You know, you could install a player such as amp. You know, I have a power amp. It's as well family in my ROMs. You know, you can use it, and after some weeks you can decide if you want to buy the application. So, you know, I'm really happy with how the thing runs, especially now in 2021. I mean, like, you know, the ROMs before, they affect, yeah, how can you say, they were good, but maybe sometimes a little bit too much. And maybe thanks to better sites that we got now, I can bring even a better experience to this tablet by using the right applications. Okay, so I have two ROMs created. One is a TV ROM. I call that Fair TV OS. It's AOSP with a TV skill on top of it, no big deal. It looks amazing after installing it. You will get into this screen here. And this is, yeah, your TV screen. It immediately already wants to play TV. It plays nice live TV. We can watch some live channels as well. Such as, depending on Germany, whenever, you know, it's open to other regions, you can go ahead and watch it. We have World TV, thanks to the amazing World app. It's just a nice system that I'm not gonna install because I already installed it and it takes a little to install. Okay, you came from my other video where I put a link to this video, and here are just ROMs that you can go ahead and install if you wish. Okay, these are really nice ROMs. I can demonstrate it for you. I just updated the YouTube app. The YouTube app in this ROM that I have is not working too good, so I just updated it. About World TV, we as well have World TV, thanks to the site that I copied to app. Okay, and probably next week I will have to create another app again, but this thing will play CNN for you. You see that? Is it playing? Oh no.
Germany, Jim and Poppy.
An it will even play in full screen. Hospital has been put it takes a little to load the full screen.
Accepting no patients since Thursday because of this new variant. They are testing all staff, all personnel.
You see that? So,
to staff so that they can only
I'm kind of happy about the system because
they are hoping that it is not out in the city.
I'm kind of happy about the system because in the previous build, we were dealing with USTVGo.tv, and that site is streaming in a way too high bandwidth, and so these devices could not, you know, deal with that stream. So that's why it was always buffering. But now that buffering is over, we have a great player here. As I told you, Power Amp is built in. Here it is. What is it saying? Allow Power Amp, yes. a beautiful player that you can use to listen to music. It will as well activate the digital and analog converter in your device, and you will be able to set a nice bitrate output for playing. So yeah, all in all, a very nice ROM. It boots just effect like the other Fair TV OSs that you saw, the nice living room with the TV, you know, that's how it boots. This is for the other device. I made a nice BlackBerry ROM, okay, as well, because BlackBerry is, yeah, the BlackBerry playbook, it's over for the BlackBerry playbook, and some of you still have that device, and you know, you're missing out that device, and now you have a nice ROM that you can install. It will not come out of the box like this, okay? You will have to long press and go to settings, and then in the settings you will have to select the icon pack. In fact, this is Nova Launcher, so you can make it just the way you wish. And I already showed in a previous video how to set up the BlackBerry system to make it look this way, okay? You have all the icons on board. Long press on the icon, you can change the icon. You will find the BlackBerry, this app here, you will find it in there, the BB10 app, I think it's called, how it's called? Yes, BB10 icon pack, rotation works, everything works nice. It's a lovely system that you want to, that you would like to have on your, you know, on your P4, or maybe even the P4 Wi-Fi, or the THG, or the THG. There's another model, third model. I will probably as well, you know, make a ROM for that device if it's if somebody requests it, because yeah, then you must request it fast and not in 1 month from now, because then I forget about the project. I'm then busy with other things. So only if you have the P4 TMO, that I have the ROM here. So the P4 TMO can as well get one. This one I'm using on daily basis to watch CNN and live TV while I'm working here in my studio. And the other one, I'm using that one, well, in fact, yeah, if you have so much devices, what do you do with all these devices? Well, I make reviews about them. In the first place, these things are movie stars. Yeah, all these devices are movie stars. This one, I just have here in the studio, and I modeled it this way, just to keep the BlackBerry playbook alive. This is a 10-inch, not really playbook, but hey, an Android device that is dressed a bit in the style of BlackBerry, you know, and it works very nice. There is no telephony in this thing available. I removed that all. There's no camera available, so this thing will not look at you. That is for both ROMs, okay? And no messaging, okay? So the phone part is removed out of the 3G version. And I found out that the system even became a bit more smoother, faster. I don't know. Maybe it's just an illusion. But those are removed, so you cannot make pictures. You cannot make phone calls. If you want the SIM card version, then I'm not even sure if the SIM card is working in the official versions from DCAT-F. So I will as well link you up to those builds, so you can choose what you want, if you want these modeled versions or if you want the not modeled versions. In both cases, the ROMs are just the same, you know, no extra development or so. I'm just the dress man, you know, I dress the ROMs, especially great ROMs that were once created and that are effect eating dust out there. I find that these devices can still be usable, as I said, as a kitchen device, as you know, many things you can do with it. Just install the right applications, you know. And if you don't know what to install, then I will make these modeled concept devices, in fact, utilizing these devices into something that you will be able to use for the rest of its life. It will always be able to play music for you until the day that it dies. It will always be able to play YouTube for you, as long as YouTube don't change all sorts of codecs there at the website for the coming years. That should be good possible. As well other websites, it should be able to open. And yeah, if websites stay kind of the same they are now, then you won't have any problem with opening websites with this device, even though maybe browsers might get outdated. But you're dealing with the latest Firefox Lite browser in this thing, the latest apps that I, you know, updated for this device. And certain are not to be updated, certain are just to be what they are, such as the scanner radio. Nice little scanner radio, works on all builds of Android. This is really amazing and works good. So yeah, things like that, you know, these are just great applications that I once inserted and never got rid of anymore. Only they are being updated. Well, of course, from out the Aurora store, you can update these things. And if you go to F-Droid, you can as well download Aurora Droid, put it in, you know, and see how many applications you can as well download from the Aurora Droid. It's an application store with lots of repositories that you can sync. You must select them all. You can select all, and then to select all, and then you can, you know, sync your device with that store, and then you're gonna have thousands of, well, at least many apps. Okay, I saw things there that I never knew that they even existed, you know, a mic that you can make, a microphone that you can connect to some mixer table, you know, and use this thing as a microphone. Of course, you could as well record to the phone, but you know, maybe you want to use the thing as a microphone to, on stage. That's possible thanks to applications that you can install, and just you just install a little jack from the output to the big PA, and then suddenly you can talk. Only thing you have to do is set the volume, you know, right, and put some tones, bass, and I don't know what, to make the sound good. But this thing can be a microphone, really. So yeah, all these crazy little sort of apps you're finding, you know, name it. It's amazing to go through that development and see what kind of apps are also there. These are not commercial apps. These are not apps that come with banners or whatsoever. This is open source, you know, and really, you'll be amazed of what you're going to find in there. So I'm going to leave that up to you. You can go ahead and find Aurora Droid. Don't forget F-Droid as well, a good store. But I think Aurora Droid is even better because it has more repositories. And yeah, that's what I think. So that was it then for these two tablets. Links will be in the description. And then I want to thank you for watching. Wish you a whole lot of fun with your two devices. May they still be of any service to you. Keep using them because these are still nice devices, and they costed a whole lot of money way back. So it's, you know, if you paid a whole lot of money for them, then you probably don't want to get rid of the thing because you're seeing your money flying away. Don't worry, you can, you know, keep this thing for the rest of its life until it's just gonna die or burn or smoke will come out of it. And if that won't happen the coming 10 years with mine and I'm still alive, I will still show these tablets after 10 years. And then I'm wondering if we still gonna be on Nougat, or some new developer is like, hey, I have this device and I'm gonna continue the development for this device. You know, I say do it and go for it, because yeah, these are nice devices. I think the sources you can find at DCATF, so check out DCATF as well on XDA, okay? Because thanks to him, you know, we can still enjoy these two devices. Wish you a fantastic Monday evening. We are in a lockdown from 9 o'clock up to 4:30. We are not allowed to go on the street anymore, otherwise we get a big fine. So yeah, almost home, everything here. I need to go to the store really fast, so I'm gonna do that. Wish you a fantastic day. I already said it, and then I see you will see me in the next video again. If you think this video was cool, leave it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel. Of course, if you did not hit the notifications yet, set them to on if you want to see my face every day. If not, you know, don't even subscribe. See you in the next video. Bye bye.